Welcome back, friends. Today we are going to continue with our topic of states of matter. And in today's session, we are going to discuss about the vapor pressure mole fraction phase diagram for ideal solution. So, to discuss vitu vingi in states of matter. Lakini, naweza nikasema kwamba, here it is where states of matter and topic nzima ya states of matter starts to be enjoyable. So, to discuss hata vitu vingi kwenye liquid phase, lakini hapa, I am sure that this part is the one which is more enjoyable as compared with the other parts in the states of matter. Now, in the today's session, we are going to discuss about the vapor pressure mole fraction phase diagram for ideal solution. Now, what is the vapor pressure mole fraction? In this diagram, we are plotting vapor pressure in x-axis, and in y-axis, and mole fraction in x-axis. So we must know how the vapor pressure of a certain liquid tend to increase with the increase in the mole fraction of that liquid in the liquid component, because of mole fraction inakuwa kwenye liquid component, while vapor composition iko kwenye vapor component. So we should know how the mole fraction, the vapor pressure of a liquid tend to increase with the increase in the mole fraction of the liquid. So we shall see the drawing, how this diagram they tend to appear. But what we can explain that there is a diagram which shows the relationship between mole fraction of component present in the solution, partial vapor pressure of components, and the total vapor pressure of ideal solution. So we have three things here. We have mole fraction, and mole fraction is plotted in x-axis. So in this diagram, mole fraction of two liquids, they are represented in two different ways, as how we shall explain later in drawing these diagrams. But this diagram shows mole fraction in x-axis, then it shows partial vapor pressure of liquids. In y-axis, and then from there it showed the total vapor pressure also in y-axis. So we shall see later how this happens. So what we are saying is that from Mlelwa's law, it appears that the partial vapor pressure of a component is directly proportional to the mole fraction of the component which is present in the liquid solution. So from Mlelwa's law, let's say P naught of liquid A is equal to mole fraction of liquid A, then P of liquid A is equal to mole fraction of liquid A, then P naught of liquid A. So in this case, we are knowing that if the mole fraction increase, because this quantity is constant, so we can say P naught of liquid A, pressure of liquid A, is that proportional to mole fraction of liquid A. Because this quantity is constant, so we can say this, we can put this as the constant of proportionality. Nachokisema ni kwamba, in a mixture solution, when a composition or mole fraction of one component increases, the other one is decreased. Kwa sababu gani? We are saying that mole fraction of component, let's say A plus mole fraction of component B is equal to 1. So kama huyo hapa alikuwa 0.5, na huyo hapa atakuwa 0.5, tunakupata ngapi? 1. Lakini ni case huyu hapa ni 0.4. That means huyu hapa lazima awe 0.6 tupate 1. Au ni case huyu hapa tumemu increase amekuwa 0.7. That means huyu hapa lazima awe 0.3 kupata 1. Hiyo ndivyo ambavyo ipo kwenye liquid. So the partial vapor pressure also change accordingly. Partial vapor pressure of liquids, that means if the partial vapor pressure of component A tend to increase, the partial vapor pressure of component B tend to decrease. Why? It's because of the decrease in the mole fraction. However, sometimes because of the difference in the pure pressures, so the variation in the partial pressure will not be as much as how the mole fraction tend to change. Now, consider an ideal solution of component A and B. If liquid A is more volatile than liquid B, more volatile, that means in a vapor phase, liquid A will have higher partial pressure than liquid B, regardless of the mole fraction. So pressure of A will be greater than pressure of B. Why? It is because A is more volatile than B, more volatile than B, regardless of their mole fraction, but because of the volatility or the extent of them to vaporize to become vapor, is the one which will determine this partial pressure formation in the vapor phase. So we are saying that pressure of A is equal to mole fraction of A, then pressure not of A. The graph of PA against the mole fraction of A is a straight line which passes through the origin and has a positive slope which is equal to P naught of A. It is general form of straight line. As we know from the general form of straight line that Y is equal to MX plus C. So for our case, it is pressure of A is equal to M, which is slope, will be is equal to P naught A, then X is XA plus C, which is equal to zero. So the equation will be straight line. The equation will be straight line. So this, our slope here, it is, this one, which is constant. Our slope here, this one, and this one is our x-axis, our y-axis, our x-axis, and then our slope with this one. So now let's move to see the example of the diagram, how the diagram is, how this diagram is. So in appearance of the diagram, this is how the diagram tend to appear. Kwamba PA is equal to P naught yule pale. So diagram yetu, tukidraw, itakuwa inapia namna ile pale. Huku tutakuwa tuna vapor pressure zinaongezeka. So the pressure ya liquid A atakuwa na anaongezeka hivi, anaongezeka. Na pale tunapaita P naught A. Wakati hapa ndo pressure of A. Hii ndo pressure of A yenyewe ina vary with the mole fraction. Huku ndio mole fraction of A. Hii ni mole fraction of A. Inaanzia hapa 0. Inafika hapa mpaka kwenye moja. This is the mole fraction of A. Kona za kona, as mole fraction of A increases, the partial pressure of A increases from 0 tend to increase up to here. So mole fraction of A ikiwa ni 1, pressure A itakuwa sana yule pale. Kwa kama tuna liquid nyingine, let's say B, kama tuna component B, again graph ya B itakuwa ni kama ya A. Lakini sasa hatuwezi kuweka B tena iwe inaenda this direction. That means kama tulivyosema, mole fraction ya A inavyoongezeka, ya B inavyoongezeka inapungua. So mole fraction ya B inatakiwa ianzie huku, 0, huku ndio iwe ngapi? Iwe 1. Kwa sababu gani? Mole fraction ya A kama peta kwa 0.7, basi mole fraction ya B at this region must be 0.3, as how we have explained earlier. Kwa hiyo hapa maana yake hapa itakuwa ni mole fraction nini? Of B, mole fraction B. And then if in case tulielezea hapo kwamba if liquid A is more volatile than B, that means the partial vapor pressure of A will be greater than that of B. So we don't have the scale, but we draw this diagram. I forget it if I have a ruler here. So we draw this diagram, and then the line will appear like this way. So here we'll have the pure pressure, the pressure of P of B, and here is the pressure of B itself. This is the mole fraction of B, comes from 0 to 1. Or if we are presenting it in a percentage, it is from 0 to 100%. So this is how we can draw this diagram. And this diagram is the one which we call the vapor pressure, mole fraction, phase diagram, vapor pressure mole fraction phase diagram. So here the vapor pressure, we are labeling it the vapor pressure, then here is the vapor pressure, and here below is the mole fraction. This is how we can present this diagram. Now from the diagram tons can reduce many things. For example, tunafahamu kwamba pressure of solution will be equal to pressure of A plus pressure of B. Now the question comes to another question, but tunapataje pressure of solution? Pressure of solution will be a straight line ambayo itakuwa ina pass kutoka hapa kwenda hapa. This will be the pressure of solution. So depending on the combination of A and B, the total pressure, which is the pressure of solution, will form a line like this one in the ideal solution. This will be the pressure of solution. Na ndo maana ujue kwamba e pressure of solution, in case B ndo may exist peke yake, pressure of solution will be equal to this one. In case A may exist peke yake, pressure of solution will be equal to this one. Now this is the how we can calculate a pressure of solution from Dalton's law. And as we know that pressure of A is equal to mole fraction of A, then pure pressure of A, then pressure of B will be equal to mole fraction of B, then pressure naught of B. So tukitaka kupata moja wapo, let's say pressure of solution can be equal to mole fraction of A, pressure naught of A, plus mole fraction of B, pressure naught of B. Or in other words, this will be equal to mole fraction of A, pressure naught of A, plus mole fraction of B, which is 1 minus mole fraction of A, pressure naught of B. But all of these are calculation and substitution, we know them from our calculation of roots row. Now from here, tunatafuta, let's say tuwe tuna x-axis. Let's say tuwe tuna x-axis. So kama tunataka tuwe tuna x-axis, tunaweza kusema hivi from our calculation yapa kwamba pressure of solution is equal to pressure naught of A, then pressure naught of B we have. So tunaweza kusema to make subject P solution ukuiwe pressure naught of A. So P of solution will be is equal to mole fraction of A, pressure naught of A, then plus 1 minus mole fraction of A, then pressure naught of B. So P of solution will be is equal to hapo tutakuja kupata mole fraction of A, P naught of A, plus tukimultiply hapo tutapata P naught of B, then hapo tutapata negative mole fraction of A, P naught of B. So hii tukija kuweka hapo itakuwa P solution is equal to mole fraction of A minus mole fraction of A, P naught of A, minus mole fraction of A, P naught of B, plus P naught of B. So P ya solution itakuwa sana tukifactor out mole fraction of A, P naught of A, minus P naught of B, then mole fraction of A, which is outside, plus P naught of B. So P solution ndio nini kwenye equation yetu line. This is Y is equal to, this is the slope with the difference between these pure pressures M, then this is our X plus this one is C. So kama iko hivi manake y intercept ya e graph yetu tutakuwa ni P naught of B. Kwa hiyo itaanzia kwenye P naught of B, na ndio maana unaona hapa tumechora, tumeanzia kwenye P naught of B. So on y axis y intercept itaanzia P naught of B, then slope will be the difference between pressure of A and pressure of B, and then this is mole fraction of A. So mole fraction of A ina change toka hapa kwenda 1. So if the x increases, the mole fraction of A increases also, the graph tend to increase. So even if ambavyo tunaweza tukaelezea kwamba kwa nini hii line tumeichora, it's because of this equation. So this equation is valid in case liquid A is more volatile than liquid B. Is valid in case liquid A is more volatile than liquid B. So in case liquid B is more volatile than liquid A, equation in a reverse, equation reverse. This corresponds to the equation of straight line of pressure of solution on y axis against mole fraction on x axis, with the slope pressure of A. Okay, sorry. With the slope pressure of A minus pure pressure of B, and the y intercept of pure pressure of B. So pressure of solution itakuwa sana hiyo. Unaona y ndio ile pale, then slope ni ile pale, x ni ile pale, na y intercept ile pale. To get the vapour pressure of the mixture or solution, we add the partial pressure of A and B together at each composition. The net effect gives the straight line. So unakuja kuona tunataka ku present the pressure of solution. In this case tunakuwa tunatumia diagram kama hiyo. This is similar to what I've drawn here, that this is the total pressure of solution. This is the total pressure of solution. So we have pressure of A in this line, pressure of B in this line, total pressure of solution in that line. So this diagram is the one which is called the mole fraction, vapor pressure mole fraction phase diagram. Vapor pressure mole fraction phase diagram. So this marks the end of our session. In the next session, we'll be discussing about the temperature composition curve for ideal solution. Temperature composition curve for ideal solution. Don't forget to subscribe the channel and to share the link of this video to your fellow students. If you need these notes, just visit the Kipaji app and then you will get the notes from session one of Status of Matter to the end in a very low cost. So just go there and buy the notes, then you can get them for reading. Thank you, and later wish you nice studies.